Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are going to discuss paper code 730. This is previous year question paper, and in this paper we have already covered question number 1 to 50. In this presentation we will cover question number 51 to 75. Question number 51 is radius of a cylinder is 10 cm. And height is 4 cm. The number of centimeter that may be added either to the radius or to the height to get the same increase in the volume. So volume is pi r square h, and here pi r square h r1 h1. This is the volume, and we have to you can cancel from pi to pi. So r square h, let's say take 10 into 10 into 10. This you can take R as example, and we have 10. Sorry, already it is given 10 and 4. It is given 10 and or radius is given 10, doing 10 into 10, and that is 4. So that is equal to 400. Now, number of centimeter that may be added to either side. So if you find such kind of question, you always try to take from the option. Let's say if 5 is increased radius, then it will be equal to 15 into 15 into 4. That is equal to 225 into 4, that is 900. And again, if the height is increased, 10 into 10 into 5, 4 plus 5, that is 9. Here we have increased 5 radius. Here in this case, we are increasing height. So it is also 900. So volume in both cases same. So answer should be A. If I would have taken B option, let's say 4, then it would have been 14 into 14 into 4, and in other case 10 into 10 into 8. So but this is not equal to 800. So this is not possible. Similarly, if increased 25, then it would have been 35 into 35 into 4, and 10 into 10 into 25 plus 4, that is 29. This is also 2900. This is not 2900, so this is also not possible. Similarly, in this case, so only A is the option when radius is increased 5, height is also increased 5 in this case, then both cases volume is equal, same increase in the volume. So in A option, it is possible. Answer is E. Next question, question number 52. If a solid cone of volume 27 pi centimeter cube is kept inside a hollow cylinder whose radius and height are that of the cone, then the volume of the water needed to fill the empty space would be how much? Solid cone of volume is kept inside a hollow cylinder. In other words, this is hollow cylinder like this, and solid cone is kept inside this solid like this. Solid cone is kept in this, and radius, whose radius and height are that of the cone. Radius and height are same that of cone. The volume of the water needed to fill the empty space, we have to find the volume of this. In other words, if I subtract the volume of cone from the volume of cylinder, then we will get the answer, because this would be the same. So volume of cylinder would be, volume of cylinder is pi r square h, and here it is equal to minus 27 pi, and volume of pi is, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h is equal to 27 pi. In other words, here it is 27 pi cancel. So r square h is equal to 81. R square h is 81. So here you can write 81. 81 pi minus 27 pi. 81 pi minus 27 pi. In other words, you can say 54 pi is the empty space. 54 pi, C should be the answer. Next question, Question number 53. In a triangle ABC, AB plus BC is equal to 12, BC plus CA is equal to 14, and CA plus AB is equal to 18. Find the radius of the circle which has the same perimeter as the triangle. So AB plus BC plus CA, this is the perimeter, and this is 2 times, because A plus B, if you add all, you will have 2 times AB, 2 times BCA, 2 times CA. So that is equal to 12 plus 14 plus 18, which is equal to 14 plus 26 plus 18, 44. So AB plus BC plus CA, which is the perimeter of triangle, perimeter of triangle, would be equal to, you can say 22, would be equal to 22. And this is the all, this is also the perimeter of circle. Find the radius of the circle which has the same perimeter as the triangle. So 2 pi r is equal to 22. In other words, 2 into 22 by 7 into r is equal to 22. R is equal to 7 by 2. R is equal to 7 by 2. We have to find the radius of the circle. 7 by 2 should be the answer is B. Question number 54. A playground is in a shape of a rectangle. A sum of rupees 1000 was spent to make the ground usable at the rate of 25 paisa per square meter. It means 25 paisa per square meter. So area of playground is, area of playground would be how much? 1000 is the rupees, and on 1 you can say 25 paisa, so it multiplied by 4, you will get 4000. So you can say 4000 into 2.25 is equal to 1000 rupees, because 1 square centimeter is equal to 0.25, that is 1 by 4. If I multiplied 4000 into 1 by 4, that is equal to 1000 rupees. So area of the ground is, which is rectangle, 4000. Breadth of the ground is 50 meter. So L into B, in other words, L into 25 is equal to 4000. L is equal to, this is 50, sorry, 50. L is equal to 80. 80 into 50, 4000. So length is 80. If the length of the ground is increased by 20 meter, it means now it will become 100. 100 length, and breadth is already given, which is 50. So area would be now 5000 meter. Area is 5000 meter. What will be the expenditure in rupees at the same rate per square meter? Same rate per square meter, which is equal to 0.25. So into 0.25, that is 1 by 4. Which will be equal to 1250 rupees. 1250 A should be the answer. Next question, question number 55. 2 centimeter of rain has fallen on a square kilometer of land. Square kilometer of land, what does it mean? Square kilometer is 100 into 100. In one kilometer, 1000 into 1000. So it will be equal to 10 power 6. 10 power 6 meter square is equal to 1 square kilometer. Assessing that 50% of the rain drop could have been collected and contained in a pool having a 100 meter and a 10 meter base, by what level would the water level in the pool have increased? Now, volume of this rain, this is 2 centimeter. And this is L into B, you can say, or you can say square, A into A into this is height, which is 2. So 2 centimeter, you can write 2 by 100 into 1000 into 1000, which is equal to 100 meter into 10 meter into H. But we have to find the 50% of the rain drop. It means It means 2 by 100 you can write here. 1000 into 1000, and you can write here this is 1000, but 1 by 2 because 50%, that is 1 by 2. Now 2 you can cancel with 2, 3 you can cancel with 3, 2 you cancel with 2, so we will have 10. 10 meter is the answer because we have taken everything in meter. Answer is B. Next question, question number 56. A cylindrical can whose base is horizontal and is of internal radius 3.5 cm contains sufficient water so that when a solid sphere is placed inside, water just covers the sphere. The sphere fits in the can exactly. The depth of the water in the can before the sphere was put in. This is cylinder. You can say which is can, cylindrical can, and already there is some water. There is some water. Now one sphere whose radius is internal radius is 3.5 here. When a solid sphere is placed inside water, just cover the sphere. The sphere fit in it exactly. Means sphere would be like this. Is like this. It means height in this case is 3.5 plus 3.5, you can say this is 7, and radius is 3.5. So due to the volume of this, the water will rise and will cover entire can. You can say this. So if I subtract the volume of from the volume of a cylinder of what volume of a volume of this sphere, then we will get the, you can say the volume of a rest water, and from that we can find the height. There is one way of thinking that. So now area volume of cylinder is equal to pi r square and h is equal to, you can say 2r, so you can write here, in fact you can write pi 2, instead of writing 2r you can write here 2, and r you can write r3 instead of r2, and minus 4 by 3 pi r cube. So we have subtracted volume of sphere from the volume of a cylinder, which is equal to pi r 3, you can take common, 2 minus 4 by 3, so it should be equal to pi r 3, and 6 minus 4, that is 2 by 3. This is the volume of, in fact, this water, and that should be equal to pi r square h, means the initial volume of the pi r square, this is the area of the base, and height is the initial water level, and I have written that in the form of h. So it should be equal to pi, you can cancel with pi, r square you can cancel with r, because this is here 3 r 3, and it has cancelled. So h is equal to 2 by 3 r, and 2 by 3 or r is already 3.5, you can say 7 by 2, so h is equal to 7 by 3, c should be the answer. Next question, question number 57. The length of three median of a triangle are 9, 12 and 15. Area of the triangle is how much? Area of the triangle, now this is 9, 12 and 15. So 9 it will be 6, 3, and 12 that is 8, 4. So we have 6, 8, it means this is triplet 6, 8, 10, this is triplet 6, 8, 10, so there will be three triangle of the same area. So 1 by 2, base is equal to 6, you can take, height is equal to 6, 8, because this is base and height. Similarly, 6, 8, 10, base, height, and that is equal to 24. So one area is 24, area of one triangle, and there are three equal area triangle in when there is a median, intersection from the median. So 24 into 3, 74 should be the answer, 72 should be the answer. Answer is B. Next question, question number 58. Height of a circular cylinder is increased 6 times and the base area is decreased to 1/9 of its value. To 1/9 of its value. The factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder increases. The factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder increases. This is cylinder, the height and R. So base area, base is pi R square. It is decreased 1/9 of value. 1/9 of value. For example, let's say this was 3. Initially it was 3, then pi, that is 9. And it is now area is decreased, base of area is decreased by 1/9. It means it has become pi. It has been, in other words, R was 3, then it has become 1 by 9 by pi, 9 pi is area and pi is after reducing. Similarly, earlier if the height is 10, now it has become 6 times, that is 60. 6 times height has become, earlier if 10, now it has become 60, and if it earlier 9, 3 was the R has become 3 to 1. Earlier 3, now it has become 1. So now what is the question? Factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder. What is the lateral surface? 2 pi R H. Now it will become 2 pi R1 H1. So you can cancel 2 pi R H. Earlier it was 10 into 3. Now it will become R, which is equal to 1, and H is becoming 60. So earlier it was 30, now it is 60, 1 is to 2 ratio. Increase will be factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder increase is 2. 2 should be the answer because 2 times it is increased. 2 times it is increased. Now the question number 59. Volume of right circular cone is 1,2,3,2 and its vertical height is 24. Its curved surface area would be how much? So what is curved surface area? Pi R L means this is curved surface area, this is curved surface area, this is cone. And volume of cone is 1/3 pi R square H. H is given 24, you can write here 24. Let me write in this. 1/3 into 22/7 into R square and into H. H is given 24, which is equal to 1,2,3,2. Volume of a cone is 1,2,3,2. Now it will be go by it. R square is equal to 21 into 7 into 7, that is 7 square, and R is equal to 7. So we could find the value of R, that is 7. Height already given 24. So 7 × 24 triplet is 25. Pythagoras triplet is 7 × 24 = 25. You must remember two important triplet. So pi is equal to 22/7, R is equal to 7, and L is equal to 25. 550 should be the curved surface area. Answer is B. Next question, question number 60. A circle and rectangle have the same perimeter. side of the rectangle are 18 centimeter and 26 centimeter. Area of the circle would be how much? They have same parameter. You can say parameter of rectangle would be 18 plus 26 and into 2. So it will be equal to 44 into 2, 88, which is equal to 2 pi r, 88. In other words, r is equal to, pi r is equal to 44. What is the question? Area of the circle, we have to tell. So 22 by 7 into r is equal to 44. R would be equal to 12. And pi r square, that is 22 by 7, r square 14 into 14, would be equal to 28 into 22. That should be equal to, first digit will be 2 into 8, 16. So there is no need to further calculate because this should be the answer. Next question, question number 61. Area of circle is increased by 22 centimeter square. When its radius increased by 1 centimeter, the original radius of the circle would be how much? What is the question? Pi r plus 1 square minus pi r square is equal to 22. This is the question. This is the question. So you can take common 22 by 7 and then r plus 1, r square plus 1 plus 2r minus r square is equal to 22. You can cancel 22. So r square cancel. 2r is equal to 7 and minus 6, minus 1, that is 6, r is equal to 3. What is the question? Original radius. Original radius r is equal to 3. Next question, question number 62. Sum of all interior angle of a regular polygon is twice the sum of all its exterior angle. In other words, you can say x plus 2x is equal to 180. Why? Because if you divide interior angle, sum means, for example, this is 6. So there are factor is 6. So that's why one interior angle and exterior angle, the ratio would be the same as the sum. So 2x plus x is equal to 180. 3x is equal to 180. X is equal to 60. X is equal to 60. So this is 60, this would be 120. What is the question? Number of side of the polygon. So 360. Smaller angle is always exterior angle. So sum of exterior angle is 360. So 360 divided by 60, that is 6, should be the number of side. Question number 63. Height of a right prism with a square base is 15 centimeter. If the area of the total surface of the prism is 608, this is square base, you can say. This is the square base of the prism. Height is 15 and total surface area 608 and base is square. Base is square. So what is the total surface area? Would be area which is a square. This area, that is a square. So this would be plus lateral surface area, which is equal to perimeter into height, and perimeter would be 4a into h. 4a into h, h is 15. And now total is 608. So already everything is given. You can say 2a square plus 60a minus 608 is equal to 0. This has become quadratic waste type. We have to find the volume. It means if we know the value of a, we can find the value of a, we can find the value of a area of the base into height. A square into h we can find. So you can, this is equal to a square plus 30a minus 304. A square plus, always make factors of this if it is difficult to make the factors. So otherwise 38 minus 8 can be 38a, 38 a minus 8 a minus 8 a minus 304 is equal to 0. So a would be a plus 38 and minus 8 a plus 38. So a minus 8 and a plus 38. In other words, a is equal to 8. A is equal to 8. So a square h is equal to 8 into h is 15. 15 into 8, 120. 120 into 8, 960 should be the volume. So what we have done, we could find the value of a, then a square h. You understand? And always prism is analogous to a cylinder. Question number 64. If the diagonal of a rhombus are 8 and 6, then the square of its size would be how much? So this is, these are diagonal 6, 8. 6 means 3 and 3, 8 would be 4 and 4, and this is 90 degree, then this would be 5. Pythagoras triplet, this is 90 degree, 3, 4, 5. So the square of its size would be 5 into 5. If this a square would be equal to, if this is a square would be equal to 5 into 5, 25 would be the answer. Next question number 65. Next one, 65. The volume of solid hemisphere is 19404 centimeter cube. Its total surface area would be how much? So volume is 2 by 3 pi r cube, and we have to find 3 pi r square, because total surface area would be of cylinder hemisphere, that is 2 pi r square and plus this pi r square, 3 pi r square. We have to find the value of 3 pi r square, and 2 pi r cube is equal to 19. In other words, let me write into 22 by 7 into r cube, which is equal to 19404. That should be equal to 24, it will be equal to 441 r cube. 441, you can write 21 into 21, and this is also 21. So r is equal to 21, and we have to find the value of this. So 3 into 22 by 7 into r square, that is 21 into 21. This should be the answer. This should be the answer. So it should be 60.4158 should be the answer. Answer is A. Next question, question number 66. If m and n are positive integer and m minus 1 is an even number, then m square minus n square will be always divisible by. So you can put value, let's say m and n is an even number, 4 and 2, m and n. This is equal to 4 minus 2, that is 2, which is even number. So m square minus n square will be always divisible by m square, that is 4 square, n square, that is 2 into 2, that is 16 minus 4. 16 minus 4 would be equal to 12. Will always be divisible by. It means either it should be divisible by 12. However, it can also be divisible by 4. So to verify further, let's write here in place of 4 and 2, you can write here minus 8 and 4. This is equal to 4. So 8 square minus 4 square. Minus 4 square. It should be equal to 64 minus 16. But here this is also divided by 4 and 12. 4 and 12. So another thing you have to take is 6, let's say 6 and 4, and 4, 36 minus 16, that is 20. 20 is not divided by 12, but it is divided by 4. So it must always be divided by 4. Question number 67. If x plus 1 by x square is equal to 3, then the value of x72 plus x66 plus x54 plus x36 plus x24 plus x6 plus 1. So you always know, you must know that x plus 1 by x is equal to root 3. If I put both sides, then it will become that. And this is equal to, when you solve further, it will become x6 plus 1. This you must memorize it. Otherwise, you have to cubing both sides, then you will get ultimately this when you solve this. But you must know this, because this is tier 2 exam, not tier 1 exam. And you need to save time, and this is frequently asked question of this pattern. So x square plus 1, or in other words, x6 is equal to minus 1. So you can put here value minus 1. Minus 1 into 70, power 72, that would be equal to 1. Here you can write, this is also equal to, this you can write, let me, x6 and 12 plus x11 into 6. x6 and 11, and then plus x6 and 9 plus x6 and 6 plus x4 and 6 plus x6 plus 1, which is equal to 0 we have taken. So x6 minus 1 power 12 is equal to 1. x6, that is minus 1 into 11, would be equal to minus 1. Sorry, minus 1 plus, this is equal to 9. Minus 1 power 9 would be minus 1, and then it will be plus 1, and then it will plus 1 and 0. So it should be equal to 1. 1 should be the answer. Answer is A. What we have done, that we must know immediately x power 6 is equal to minus 1, or x6 plus 1 is equal to 0. These two you have to use in this expression. Next question, question number 68. If a plus b plus c is equal to 0, then the value of a square plus b square plus c square divided by a square minus bc would be how much? You can put value here, let's say 3 minus 2 minus 1 is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. So 3 square, that is 9, plus minus 2 square, that is 4, minus 1 square, that is 1, 3 square, that is 9, minus 2 and minus 1, that is 2, 2, you can say minus 2 would be 9 minus 2. So 14 divided by 7 would be equal to 2. 2 is the answer, C is the answer. You can put value and so like this. Question number 69. If n is equal to 7 plus 4 root 3, then the value of root n plus 1 by root n. We have to find the value of this. So you can write this expression in this term. This is root 3, 2 plus root 3. Square of this would be equal to, this is equal to 2 plus root 3. If you open this bracket, you will find this. 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2 into root 3 into 2. Now, we know 2 plus root 3 here. And when the multiplication, you rationalize it, and when the difference is 1, square difference is 1, then just change the sign. Just change sign, then 2 plus 2 would be 4. We have rationalized it internally, in fact, and I just said that the difference is 1 after squaring, then just change the sign only. So 2 plus root 3 plus 2 minus root 3 would be equal to 4. 4 is answer. Answer is B. Next question, question number 70. If a plus b plus c is equal to 6, a square plus b square plus c square is equal to 40, then a3 plus b3 plus c3 is equal to 36. Then the value of abc would be how much? So put, try to put value. It is possible. And this can be if this is 3, this is 2, this is 1, this is 6, 9 plus 4 plus 1, that is 12, and then A3, that is 3 power 3, 77, and B, that is 2 power 3, 8, and plus 1, 36. So this is satisfied. A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, and C is equal to 1. Then 3 into 2 into 1 would be equal to 6. Answer is B. We have put the value A, B, C. Next question, question number 71. If A, B are rational number, A minus B, A minus 1 root 2 plus 3 is equal to B root 2 plus A, the value of A, B would be how much? Now in C, in this equation, A minus 1 and root 2 plus 3 is equal to B root 2 plus A. In this expression, see, root 2 here, root 2 here. So A minus 1 should be equal to B, and 3 is equal to B, A. 3 is equal to A here, and in this expression root 2 here it is mentioned. From this root 2, we can define this expression in this way. A minus 1 is equal to, which is a B. In place of B, we have written A minus 1. So A, what is the question? A plus B would be how much? Now B is equal to 3. So A minus 1 is equal to 3. A is equal to 4. We have to find the value of A plus B. So A is equal to 3. So 3 minus 1, 2. B is equal to then 2, and A is equal to 3. A plus B would be equal to 5. Answer is D. Next question, question number 72. The graph of the linear equation 3x plus 4y is equal to 24 is a straight line intersecting x-axis and y-axis at the point A and B respectively. These are two coordinate, x and y, minus x, you can write minus y. 3x plus 4y is equal to 24 is a straight line intersecting x-axis and y-axis. I mean, this would be like this. So let's define this. 3x plus 4y, 3x plus 4y is equal to 24. In other words, if I put here y 0, then it will be equal to 3x. 24, x is equal to 8, and I put here x is equal to 0, then y, 4y is equal to 24, y is equal to 6. So y is equal to 6 and x is equal to 8. Intersecting line cutting x and y would be, then the length would be 10. 6, 8, 10, Pythagoras triplet. What is the next in this question? P2, 20 and Q, 0, 3 by 2 are the two points on side OA. This is O, and these are at point A and B respectively. X axis A, and this is A, and this is B. So OA and OB, it is given. Now P, which is a point at 2, here this is 8, so it means 2 would be like here, 2 and 0, x, y, 0. So we have written like this. And here Q is equal to, which is on OB, 3 by 2, it will be 3 by 2, 3 by 2. Y is, x is 0 and y is 3 by 2. So this would be like this, 3 by 2, and this is 2. What is the question? Where O is the origin of the coordinate system, this entire system, O is the origin. So given that AB is 10, obviously this is, we can could find the value of AB is 10, then PQ would be how much? We have to find the value of P and Q. So if this is 2, let's find the volume of this. Volume of smaller triangle, that is 1 by 2 into base into height. 1 by 2 base 3 into height 3 by 2. So it should be equal to 3 by 2. This is the area. Area 3 by 2 you can write here. And area of this would be equal to 3 by 2 square plus 2 square should be equal to 9 by 4 plus 4, that is 9 plus 16, 25 by 4. Root of this would be equal to 5 by 2. Root of this would be equal to 5 by 2. So this should be equal to 5 by 2. 5 by 2, that is B should be the answer. B should be the answer. Question number 73. Area of the triangle formed by the straight line 3x plus 2y 6 and the coordinate axis x minus x y and minus y. Area of the triangle formed by the straight line 3x plus 2y is equal to 6. Let's say if x is 0, 2y would be equal to 6, y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 3. And y is equal to 3 when x is equal to 0. 0, 3, you can write x, y. And here, if y is equal to 0, then x would be equal to 2. If I put y is equal to 0, 3x is equal to 6, x is equal to 2. 2 and 0, y is equal to 0 here. So, this is 2 and this is 3. We have to find the area of area of the triangle. So, 1 by 2 base, that is 2 into height. 3 units should be the area. Answer is A. Next question, question number 74. Length of the intercept of the graph of the equation 9x minus 12y is equal to 108 between the two axes. Between the two axes, length of the intercept of the graph of the equation 9x minus 12y. 9x would be equal to, if we put y is equal to 0, then 108, x is equal to 12. So here we have written x is equal to 12. This is x, this is minus x, y and minus y. Now if I put x is equal to 0, then minus 12y would be 108, y is equal to minus 9. So here you write minus this side, minus 9 is 12. We have to find the length of the intercept of the graph. This is the graph, length of the intercept of this graph. We have to find the value of this. So 9, 12. This would be equal to 15 because of Pythagoras triplet. 9, 12 and 15 Pythagoras triplet. Answer is A. Next question, question number 75. If x plus 1 by x square is equal to 3, then the value of x 206 plus x 200 plus x 90 plus x 64 plus x 18, this would be. Same two, you can a similar kind of question, two questions have come in this presentation. And this is previous year question paper. So SSC repeat even variety is in same question paper. And this is equal to, as I told you earlier also, x6 plus 1 is equal to 0 or x6 is equal to minus 1. In this format you can write to this. When x plus 1 by x, if you root both sides, then you will have x plus 1 by x root 3. And if you cube both sides, then you will get, so you have to remember this in this kind of question, because this is a frequently asked question. Now write here x is equal to minus 1. In this question you can write, here x and then 200, x 6 plus 1. Why? Now it has become x 206 and x power 200. And here you write x 84, then x 6 plus 1 and then plus x power 12, x 6 plus 1, x 6 plus 1 and then x 6 plus 1. So this is 0 already given. This is become 0 because you multiply it by 0, then it will become 0. This is also 0, this is also 0. So everything is 0. Answer is 0. Answer is A. Question number 75. So such kind of question you can solve even without pen. If you know this, then you can put in your mind that how we will solve this. So in this presentation we have covered over question number 51 to 75. In the next presentation, you will cover question number 76 to 100. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.